While a meteor is presumed to have caused the last great extinction event in our planet's history 66 million years ago, the Earth had already gone through many more in the thousands of millions of years that existed before. Today, we're not going back in time centuries, we're going back literal eons, and might even discuss an extinction event unfolding right now. But before that, make sure to get subscribed so you never miss another piece of history your school textbooks glossed over. First of all, what is an extinction event? Well, it's also known as a mass extinction or biotic crisis, meaning that through some chain of events, an inordinate amount of life on the planet ceased to exist. These events can take a long period of time and only affect a small proportion of planetary life, like the thawing of an ice age, or they can be cataclysmic and violent, caused by extraterrestrial impacts that blot out the sun. To date, scientists believe that the Earth has experienced 6 major extinction events, and may be in the midst of one right now. We'll cover the current one later. Now, it's not considered one of the 6 major events, but I wanted to give it an honorable mention. The Great Oxygenation Event, 2400 million years ago. It's the Earth's first known extinction event, and actually took place because algae had just developed photosynthesis. Growing out of control, the atmosphere became saturated with so much oxygen it killed off much of the life on Earth. This, however, had an enormously positive effect overall. It meant Earth's atmosphere was flush with energy, energy that multicellular organisms could take advantage of through respiration in the eons to come. The first of planet Earth's major extinction events is the Ordovician-Silurian extinction event, taking place between 450 and 440 million years ago. This extinction came in waves, first caused by a gamma ray burst coming from a hypernova. The burst is believed to have destroyed the Earth's ozone layer, depleting vast swaths of the ocean in the ensuing heat, which then caused the death of the algae that is providing all that new oxygen to the planet. From there, parts of the ocean floor dissolved into the sea, introducing toxic metals to the waters, causing more death before planetary glaciation took over. The victims this time were mostly trilobites, corals, and bivalves. The late Devonian period was marked by the evolution of plants into trees. In this span of time, plants went from being 1 foot tall to 10 feet in height. This, of course, meant even more oxygen and the beginning of legged creatures on Earth. This extinction almost exclusively affected the oceans, killing off 75% of species as a result of meteors, UV damage, the overgrowth of plants, and volcanic activity. A quick aside here, I did run into something fascinating in research about this era that I have to share. At this point in time, trees were taking over, but fungi and bacteria that break down wood and plant material hadn't made it quite to the scene yet. Without anything to break wood down, it simply piled up, and with a spark, enormous infernos could ravage the entire planet, burning away the wood and replenishing the atmosphere with CO2 for new trees. Before this period, plants were too small and wet to produce massive infernos, so this extinction event may have been fueled by the evolutionary inception of the wildfire on planet Earth. Now, the next 3 extinction events were less cataclysmic and shared similar causes. In the Capthian extinction event, continental collisions increased ocean salinity, killed off many ammonoids and coral builders. On land, cat-sized therapsids took the brunt of the damage. The Permian-Triassic extinction event occurred just 8 million years later and finally caught up with land-dwelling species, wiping out an estimated 70% of them. Similar volcanic activity in Siberia and climate change were the likely culprits, though some scientists think stores of fossil fuels may have ignited, resulting in planetary fires and colossal explosions, wiping out much of life. The Triassic-Jurassic extinction kicked off the age of the dinosaurs 200 million years ago and was likely caused by an asteroid or comet hitting southern Canada, forming what has been observed today as the Manicouagan Reservoir. Climate during this time also evened out, as extreme habitat diversity around the planet became much more arid and temperate. Now, you heard me say dinosaurs, so you probably know what extinction event is next. The Cretaceous-Paleogene extinction, the event that wiped out the dinosaurs. This event wiped out nearly every 4-legged creature weighing over 50 pounds on the planet, only leaving modern-day dinos like crocodilians and turtles as a reminder of the era. An asteroid or comet estimated to have been nearly 10 miles across hit the Earth. Scientists believe they located the crater for this extraterrestrial object in the Yucatan, estimating it to be 112 miles across. The impact was so catastrophic it vaporized rock, not just boiling into magma, but forcing enough energy into the rock to turn it into an aerosol gas. The The impact was unlike anything the planet had ever seen or has ever seen since, releasing 420 zeta-joules of energy, more than a billion times the energy released by the atomic bombs of Japan. It hit so hard that fragments of Earth were ejected into space, then tore up the atmosphere on re-entry, not only causing the equivalent of nuclear winter, but also disrupting the atmosphere enough for cosmic radiation to literally microwave organisms to death. Over 75% of all species on Earth vanished as a result. It killed off dinosaurs, mammals, birds, insects, and even plankton. It even killed off the ammonites who had survived the previous four extinction events, thriving as the most prominent life form on Earth for a time. They had been on planet Earth for nearly 250 million years, throughout many, many perils, but even they succumbed to the Cretaceous extinction. And what happened after? Well, we're living it. Mammals rose to prominence, and lately the species Homo sapiens seems to have taken dominance. And while that may seem like a good thing, scientists still believe we're currently in the midst of another mass extinction event. The culprit this time is given away in the name. Scientists call it the Anthropocene extinction, Anthropos being Greek for human. Yes, the next mass extinction on planet Earth is being caused by humans. Since the dawn of humankind, extinction rates have risen by an order of 1,000. The first victims were the megafauna, mammoths, giant sloths, and massive armored armadillos. They're already gone. But extant species of rhino, whales, gorillas, elephants, and tigers seem to be on their way out as well. Now, humans don't always overhunt an animal like the dodo, but also outcompete them for resources, space, and even climate. Humans aren't just classified as apex predators, but as global super predators, with their appetites outmatching any other species per capita and straining the food web. According to the International Union of the Conservation of Nature, at least 875 species have gone extinct since 1500 alone, with regional extinctions ranging from 98% decline in insect groundfall in places like Puerto Rico to a 75% decline of mammal species in Germany. And while the disappearance of lesser-known species like the pagan reed warbler and Pinta Island tortoise may seem inconsequential, the dangers facing our ecosystems are apparent in the condition of our reefs and rainforests. Of course, some organizations are fighting to protect our endangered species. The Ripley's Aquariums, for example, are helping to restore and protect the African penguin. And as we're covering on Weird News Happy Hour, some labs are even finding ways to save species through cloning. But what do you think? Are humans the mass extinction event of the era, or will something else come along and challenge even us? Let me know in the comments below, and be sure to like this video if you want to learn more about the history missing from your textbooks. Subscribe so you don't miss our next video. Until then, watch out for asteroids.